Hi everyone, this is Aimée. Welcome to my channel. In my last two videos on IJS Components, I discussed skating skills and performance. In my opinion, skating skills are the most critical aspect of figure skating, and the performance component appears to win more Olympic gold medals than any other component. But still, many skaters and sometimes some coaches focus so much on that technical score that the component score is sometimes an afterthought. But putting the time into developing the criteria for program components is one of the best investments you can make in your skating. I've said it before, but it really doesn't matter how high you can jump if you can't land on the right edge. Hold your landing and skate to the next element in a skilled and beautiful way. Aside from skating skills and performance, three other components make up the IJS component score. IJS demands a rigorous understanding of requirements and criteria for component marking. Competitive figure skating programs must allow for the execution of elements while performing a composition for the best overall results. Component marks are a critical part of that score. In this video, I'll clarify the five components, and I'm going to go deep into interpretation as a component. I'll also provide you with important information that will assist you in maximizing your component scores. If we're just meeting, my name is Aimée Ricca, and I'm a PSA ranked and rated figure skating coach. I'm also an ISSA certified elite trainer, certified specialist in strength and conditioning and youth fitness, as well as a precision nutrition PN1 certified nutrition coach. I work with skaters and their families to help create change and get real results. Okay, so IJS Program Components, or PCS. If you're unfamiliar with IJS, it was developed as a collaborative global effort to produce a scoring system for figure skating that provides a precise and transparent evaluation. This is for both the technical elements and the artistic aspects of a competitive program. In scoring a competitive figure skater's performance, the marks are divided into two basic categories. Technical element score, this is for the feats of athleticism performed by the skater. And the program component score, reflecting five different artistic aspects of the program. These two categories of scoring are independent from each other, and a given program may garner higher component marks but lower scores for technical ability. Likewise, component scores may be low with higher scores for technical prowess. Additionally, grade of execution, or what we call GOE, will generally vary from element to element, and component scores will differ from one component to the next. Keep in mind that all scoring is always relative to the actual performance at that moment. Therefore, scores for the same program by the same skater can vary considerably from one competition to the next. The goal of a skating performance is seamless and meaningful movement with properly integrated and successful fulfillment of all the required elements to music. These elements form the backbone of the program, but the programs as a whole cannot be thoroughly evaluated without applying the five components. In each segment of an event, the judges award five separate program component marks to each program. There are five components in the short program and the free skate in the singles, pairs, and synchronized skating disciplines. In ice dancing, these five components are scored in the short dance and the free dance. Together, the scores of the five components will be used in a formula to make up the program component score. The program component score is calculated and factored by specified percentages. All five program component marks are factored equally, then added together. It is the factored sum of the program component marks that constitutes the program component score. This is a complicated formula, and I could spend a lot of time explaining it, but you don't want to hear me talk that long. So you can find those tables on the members only section of the US Figure Skating website. Look for the IJS and 6.0 tables. The idea behind factoring is to make the program components equal in weight to the technical element score. The technical element score combines the grades of execution for each element plus the numerical degree of difficulty assigned in the scale of values. Since the perfect non-factored program component score is always 50, this number is factored to roughly equal each discipline's score in the TES. Totaling the competition score, you take the technical element score add it to Program Component Score, and what you get is the Total Segment Score, or TSS. At the end of a competition, the skaters are given a scoring sheet. We call this a protocol. It details the evaluation results of each aspect of the program, and this protocol provides all the details of the technical elements, as well as the program components: skating skills, transitions, performance, composition, interpretation of music, or timing for ice dance. In the US, the program component mark percentages are different for juvenile, intermediate, and novice levels in singles and pairs. The junior and senior levels are derived directly from the ISU rules, and these percentages can sometimes vary from season to season. So go to that US figure skating members only area to view the current tables. Program components are marked on a scale of 0.25 to 10 in increments of 0.25, with a separate mark given for each mark component, of which 1 is very poor, 2 poor, 3 weak, 4 fair, 5 average, 6 above average, 7 good, 8 very good, 9 is excellent, 10 is outstanding. Judges evaluate each component based on its listed criteria. Errors, falls, and disruptions must be reflected in these marks. In a program containing a fall or serious error, a score of 10 shall not be awarded for any of the components. And a score of 9 or higher should not be awarded for performance and interpretation. In this video, we're focusing on interpretation. And as you can see, it's pretty important. Think of this in terms of feeling or an emotional reaction to an expressive and detailed performance. Interpretation of the music is personal, creative, and a genuine translation by the skater of the music's rhythm, character, and content to movement on the ice. As the tempo binds all notes and times, you need to demonstrate the ability to use tempos and rhythms in the music in a variety of ways. The use of finesse to reflect musical nuances creates a mastery of interpretation. The soul of the skater is intrinsically matched to the structure of the music. Their performance should be seamless. Understanding the concepts and terms are most important for understanding interpretation. Timing is the ability to keep time accurately and to synchronize your movement. Your ability to translate music through sureness of rhythm, tempo, and effective and effortless movement over the ice surface. You should demonstrate rhythmic continuity and awareness of all tempo and rhythm changes in a variety of ways. A command of movement and thorough understanding of the music will allow you to effortlessly and adequately time steps, turns, elements, and movements to the music. Suppose you disconnect from the music before a required element. In that case, you can lose your timing and the relationship with the music. You need to demonstrate a good relationship with the stroke and glide and other body movements to the correct structure of the music. The goal is to bond you, the judges, and the audience through a seamless and effortless performance. Expression of the music's character or feeling and rhythm. When clearly identifiable, rhythm is created when you add accents, notes of music. Your rhythm of steps and movement should follow that rhythm that is created by the music. Expression is the quality and appropriateness of the movement that interprets the character and style of the music. While musical selections may vary through different rhythms or tempos, they all contain phrasing structure with a question and answer pattern. This question and answer complete a whole musical sentence. Phrases make a statement by starting with a bang and finishing completed. Or you can begin them slowly and end them suddenly with excitement. If the music says something, your movements and character should correspond with that message, articulating character and meaning through a captivating performance. Every part of your body, including your facial expression, should be committed to expressing the character of your program. Use finesse to reflect the details and nuances in the music. Musical nuance provides life to the music. There are subtle variations to the intensity, tempo, and dynamics. There are details in every piece of music. Through skating movement, you define and translate those nuances to judges and the audience. Finesse is your refined, artful manipulation of the details and nuances of the piece of music through your movements. This is unique to you and should display an inner feeling for the music and composition. You should reflect the details of the music within the phrase structure. Every movement should have its own characteristic rhythm. In pairs and ice dance, demonstrate an equal and continuous awareness and relationship to each other while expressing the style and rhythm of the music. Blend and rhythmically integrate your movement with the music. Both of you need to commit to the same depth of character and interpretation so that the balance of your skating creates an entity. You and your partner need to maintain effortless movement to the designated rhythmic beat without any apparent strain. You need to appear as one as you both follow the beat and the melody of the musical selection. So, what exactly are the judges looking for from your performance? Were you connected to the music, or were there lapses of disconnection? Did you follow the timing of the music? Did you feel the character of the music through your expression? Did you use the details and nuances to enhance the performance, or were essential accents of the music ignored? Did you follow the rhythmic beat, and are you able to follow the beat and melody? Was the music memorable when the program finished? Did you leave the ice having evoked a feeling to the judges and the audience? Keep all these points in mind as you practice and prepare for the competition. Interpretation assesses your ability to bring life and feeling to the music as you communicate through the emotional aspects of the music. The more you understand musical concepts and structure, the more success you'll ultimately have in interpretation. Acknowledge details and nuances and transfer obvious form and meaning to the audience through musical and effortless expressive movement. Make sure that the mood and style of the selection are prominent in your performance. Good interpretation produces memorable programs. There are several criteria to be considered before a judge assesses a component score, and each judge will often come to the score by a different path, in that each performance being evaluated is unique. Remember, judges assess and weigh the overall criteria for each component before awarding a mark. It's pretty common to have one or more component marks that are significantly different. For example, skating skills could be 5.5, while interpretation could be 3.75. Your movement is critical to every component. Posing without movement just takes away from the aesthetic athletic quality of glide and flow of figure skating. Repetitive movements, or movement that frequently disconnects from the music, can become boring to judges and the audience. Your music should drive continuous movement. Each component and criteria will provide you with artistic skills and understanding that will enrich all aspects of your skating. So make sure you have a good primary coach that is PSA ranked and rated and focuses on the quality of your performance and all the components. Also, I've developed some worksheets that can help you out as well, and they're completely free. Just go to skatewithaimee.com/freebies and download the component checklists. These worksheets will give you an edge in competition. And if you missed my video about skating skills or the video about performance as components, there are links to them in the description down below. In future videos, I'll go over other components, transitions, composition. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and share it with someone else it could help, and just post it to your social media too. Remember to subscribe and ring that bell so that you never miss a video. This is Aimée. Happy skating. I will see you real soon. Thank you for watching. Bye.